Hello, I'm Graham Horton and welcome to today's video, which is around some of the misconceptions about the HDMI output of the Panasonic Lumix FZ80 or 82 camera. On quite a few forums and on quite a few reviews, it's stated that the Panasonic FZ80 or 82 camera can actually output a HDMI signal that you can use for streaming, or you can use it for LVS, or you can use it for Skype, those sort of things, or you can use it using the Panasonic Lumix webcam app to use it as a webcam. Unfortunately, none of those statements are correct. The Panasonic Lumix FZ80 or 82 cannot output a live stream from the HDMI port. The HDMI port can only output during replay mode. So those statements that you've seen on the internet are incorrect. Neither can you use that micro USB port. It just doesn't support the functionality that Panasonic built for their later cameras to output over USB 3. So what options do you have for streaming, if you like, with your FZ80 or 82 camera? Well, you're probably all familiar with the Panasonic Imaging app, which I've got running here on my iPad. You can see that it's quite a full-featured article. Now, if you look at some of the features of that, you can see that it's fully featured. If you're in, say, the shutter priority mode, you can actually change the shutter speed, so you can actually change your shutter speed. If you want to change to aperture priority mode, then you need to go into the camera and change that directly. You can't change the mode from the app. You can also change things like the white balance, the ISO, exposure compensation. You can change the way this focuses. You can use a touch screen of your iPad or your iPhone, in fact, or any Android device that's running this app. So if I wanted to focus over there, the camera will attempt to focus on that point, and if I wanted to pull focus back to one of the characters in the foreground, then you can do that. Of course, you can use this to capture still images, and you can use it to start and stop recording video. It also gives you access to the quick menu, so all the usual things are there for you to change. Hit the return key to come back to the main menu. And it also gives you the options to do things like photo montages and snap movies. It can geotag your images. It can transfer images from your camera to your smartphone. In terms of other devices, if you have a Microsoft Windows 10 compatible device, an Xbox platform, a PC, or indeed the Surface Pro devices, then you can use an app called Lmaster, which is available in the Microsoft Store. So if we just look in the Microsoft Store, this is on a Windows 10 PC, by the way. And if you search for apps and you type Lmaster, it brings up the Lmaster app. It's a free app. There are in-app purchases, but you really don't need to use them. It's free to use, and you can look at the reviews of it and the description in the Microsoft Store. So it says supported cameras are the GH4, GH3 and some of the GXs and G series, but in fact it will work with cameras like the FZ8 to the FZ300, 330, 1000 and 2500. So it will work with all the bridge cameras, and it will work with most of the mirrorless cameras as well that I have. So when you download that and install it, if you first of all look at the interface, you will find that you just have a blue screen which says connection. What it's looking for now is to find the hotspot that your camera creates when you put it into Wi-Fi mode. So what you would do is to select your camera, and in this case it's going to be the FZ80 82. I'm going to turn it on, go into the usual Wi-Fi menu, Wi-Fi function, new connection, remote shooting and view, because that's the only option that this app has. There's no functionality like the image app to transfer images or things like that. You'll go connect to Wi-Fi, and you should then see your camera appear in the Wi-Fi list. So click that and it will connect to the FZ82. If it's the first time you connect, then obviously you'll need to enter your passcode to get into the Wi-Fi, but once you've installed it, you'll now see that in the background there we've got the FZ8082 camera, and you can see the screen. Now it is only 640 by 480, so that's VGA resolution. That's the limit imposed by the camera stream, not by the app. So it doesn't matter what app you had that would read the Wi-Fi, in fact is a VGA signal. So it is fairly limited in what it can do, but as far as a monitor for your camera, if you're going to use this for remote shooting and view for either stills or video, then it's quite a capable device. So let's see, I've got that camera pointed, I can take a snapshot picture. And I can start and stop video. You can change the aperture if you're in aperture priority mode or the manual mode. So I can again set an aperture. And again, I'm in manual mode, so I can set a shutter speed. And it's using iAuto, so you can use the ISO values that you want. The only thing I've found it not to be able to control with the FZ8082 is the zoom. So you can't set zoom with this one. You can with the FZ300 and you can with the FZ1000, but I have found this not to work with the FZ8082. You notice you've got a focus target which you can reposition over onto the target and it will focus. If I set the target down further away, you can see it's refocused on the furthest away point back up to this point. If you hit reset, it will bring that focus point back to the center of the screen. You can see the current modes the camera's in: manual, autofocus, single area, the number of spaces left on the memory card. So it is quite a useful device, apart from the fact that the resolution is so low. So you could use this in OBS and capture that window if you wanted to put it in some presentation where screen size isn't important, but you wanted to do this at 1920 by 1080 full HD, you're not going to have so much in terms of resolution to do that. Under the settings, you can go to the settings for the camera that's been installed, so in this case it's the FZ82, click that and go to settings. You can then, if you've got an anamorphic lens on there, change the squeeze to give you that correct de-squeeze. And there's an option here to remember the camera, so it will remember the SSID and the password that you set. Now there is a problem if you do that. So if I remember this camera, that's fine. But now if I close this app down, and first of all I'll release the Wi-Fi connection from the camera, so I'm going to go into my menu, Wi-Fi function, and terminate. So it's now terminated the connection, but if I close this app down and I reopen it, you notice it comes up with a default screen and it can't connect. If you run into that situation, there is a fix for it, and if you go into Windows and into Settings, and then if you scroll down and find apps, and if you scroll down to find that particular app, Lmaster, go into advanced options, and then if you scroll down you can see we've got a reset facility, and that just clears out the cache for the settings in that particular app. Once it's done that, you'll find you'll get a tick appear here, which means it's been reset. You can close that, and now you can reopen the app and it will go back to the connection. So it will have to be a new connection, of course, remote shooting and view, and then you can go to your input again, connect to Wi-Fi, look for the FZ8082 that has come up. So it's connected, and now we've got this screen, so we can do our usual shooting. If we close the app now, and again I'll terminate the app, and now I can close the app, and when I reopen it, it will come back to the no connection. But if you save a profile in the app, you'll find that it won't restart. There are other features within the Lmaster app. If I just have a look at it again, I'll just go full screen so we can see more of it. You can see that it is poorer resolution. It is now VGA upscaled to full HD, so it is getting a little pixelated around the edges. But nevertheless, if we go to the menu, you can see that we've got full screen at the moment, but you can have split screen, so you can have two cameras, one on the upper section and one on the lower, or one on the left, one on the right, or you can indeed have four cameras. To enable that mode, you need to be connecting to your router, as this device will only see one hotspot. But if you've got the router, you can connect them to the router and have the four cameras if you wanted, so you could have four cameras in this view. But normally, you'd normally be using the one section. You can see now I've connected to the FZ330, and you notice we can use the zoom. It is unfortunately step zoom, so it will go in the steps created by Panasonic in their wisdom for the app, but at least you can control it in this app, where with the SZ8082 that hasn't been implemented for some reason. And again, you can control where the focus point is by using the on-screen target, and it will attempt to refocus on that. And again, reset puts the focus point in the middle. And as before, we're in the shutter priority mode, so I can change the shutter speed and it will automatically change the ISO if you're in auto ISO mode. So you can see on screen the current mode we're in. That's the shutter priority mode, our autofocus method, single area, number of spaces left on the memory card using the current format, battery status, which is about to run out, the fact you can record video or you can record stills, change your aperture, change your shutter speed, change your ISO if you're in a mode which will allow you to do that, and you've got the zoom facility here if you've got a camera which supports zoom. So that's the Lmaster app. So you can use this on your laptop. If you've got a portable laptop, of course, you can take it out in the field and use this to give you a monitor for your view. If you've got a Surface Pro, then that's even better. You can touch screen it and control focus points and change settings, etc., all by touch screen. Or if you've got a touch screen laptop, again, you've got that full feature functionality. So even though this is on a VGA resolution, it does give you a good monitor view of your focus and framing, etc., something you can't do with the image app at such a small screen. So even if you've got a large tablet, the screen is still quite small, and again, it's limited to VGA resolution over Wi-Fi. Whichever device you're using, you are restrained to VGA. That's a camera restraint and not the app's restraints. Well, I hope you found that useful and cleared up some of the myths around the FZ8082 HDMI output. You can't stream from it, neither can you use it as a webcam. So if you have discovered a way of making the FZ80 or 82 camera live stream or use it as a webcam, please comment below, and I'm sure the community would really appreciate that. So if you're a new viewer and you like what you see, please do hit that subscribe button and the bell notification icon, and you'll be advised when I upload new videos in the series. So until then, as usual, thanks very much for watching. Please do take care, and I hope to see you all very, very soon. Goodbye for now.